So the drums, we knew we had to go to a studio and we had to, you know, we needed Nolly basically to get the best possible drum sound we could. We couldn't do much in here, you know, the practice space is alright, but it's not a fully functioning studio yet.
We decided to do guitars and vocals by ourselves because we have a studio space, we have all the gear, and we just thought, why not? Like, it means we can be more relaxed, we can be at home. After we recorded the drums, me, Stephen and Davey, basically a few days later, went straight in to the studio and started tracking guitars and bass. We were trying not to be too relaxed about it because you can like get lazy if you're at home, and but we literally recorded every single day for 3 or 4 weeks, 6, 7, 8 hours a day. We had maybe like 2 or 3 days off tops, but we proper like worked ourselves hard.
There's not that sort of pressure on you where like we're using somebody else's time here, let's knuckle down. We did that anyway because at the end of the day our time's also important and we wanted it done first and foremost, you know. I mean, for us as well, it'd been a long time coming and we were just like, right, we've got a month, let's do it.
Fucking nearly every time, man. Maybe,
certainly,
maybe.
While we'd been at Meadow Farm recording the drums, we had a chance, we had a free day just to get some tones, and I'd actually ordered a Kemper while we were at the studio because we got there and Nolly had planned that we were going to do this, like Kemper some tones in the studio. I turned up and he was like, so did you bring your Kemper? And I was like, did you bring your Kemper? And he's like, no, did you bring yours? And I was like, I don't have a Kemper. So I kind of had to order a Kemper, like rush delivery to the studio, and we spent the whole last day just trying out different cabs and heads to try and get the best tone. So we ended up taking that profile that we made in the studio with Nolly back to the studio and recording the whole album with that, so we didn't have to like record DIs and reamp guitars. So that worked out really well. We got a tone that we're really happy with.
Even right after we release an album, Goonsie starts writing the next album straight away. He constantly writes riffs. So I think that's probably got a lot to do with why he writes 80% of our music, because he's been doing that since day one, 13 years ago. So I think it's just kind of what he does. Even if the band stopped, Goonsie would probably still continue writing Bleed Within songs.
Goonsie is such a creative guy, and he's always writing the most insane riffs. It's hard to keep up with him sometimes, but such a solid player, and he's always making me stretch my limits in the bass as well. Stephen has settled in really nicely to the band. Rowena, like, that was one of the first riffs they actually brought to the table, and as soon as I heard that, I was actually blown away, and I just knew as soon as they kind of wrote that, like, that was the kind of darker feel of the album that we needed as well. Yeah, it's actually one of my favourite songs.
Stephen is a producer, it's what he does for a living, so he knows his shit, and he's a guitarist and he's really in it. He hears things that I don't hear, like little tuning things and stuff.
Stephen and Goonsie are just—they're so talented with like production, arranging ideas and stuff like that. And I swear they must have different ears to me, because every fucking time I was playing a riff, they're like, "Oh, that's sharp or that's flat or whatever." And I'm like, "Fucking really?" But I guess it was all for the best of the album, and they definitely got the best out of me as a player. such a relaxing tracking process for me, and whenever guitars were up, and it was kind of in the middle of summer as well, so whenever guitars were up, I would take my deck and just go skating for a bit. This has definitely been the most challenging album for me, like musically, I guess. I always try and think kind of outside the box with playing bass as well.
He's got some great moments on the album. He's a shit hot bass player, and he always has been. I was in a band with him before he even joined Lead From Within, so we've kind of always had the rhythm thing going on, bass and drums.
Yeah, I usually work really close with Ali and get the rhythm section really solid, and if he's doing a certain fills or something like that, I'll try and maybe match them in the bass as well and do something kind of interesting.
Davey was solid, as always, when it came to tracking his parts. Like, there's so many little kind of accents and stuff that you'll hear on bass, so he's creating this kind of other layer of rhythm on top of everything else that's going on. He has this incredible tone as well. We got the mixes back, everybody's saying, oh, the bass is too loud, the bass is too loud, and Davey's just so happy that the bass is too loud.
Standout riff for me would be probably the end riff in Alive. It's just such a crushing riff to play, even in studio. It's really cool that me and Ali get to jam out the whole last part of the album, just me and Ali, which is something we've never really done before as well. I guess the first riff that kind of stood out to me, probably anything in Afterlife. This has always been my favourite song anyway. I just think it's kind of a nice progression from Deathwalk as well. It's almost kind of similar, but it's got its kind of own groove, I guess, as well, which suits all the songs in kind of era. It just sits in nicely there.
A lot of riffs that I really, really like on this album. I think Gatekeeper is a song. I think that was one of Stephen's sort of songs. That was his main piece. So that's a great riff. Very driving, first riff of that song. Another favourite would have to be Bed of Snakes. Pre-chorus and that again. He's really good at the pre-chorus riffs. It's Goonzy. He's got something for them. That particular moment in a song is where he comes to life. Really bouncy, really groovy. They're just, you know, they're my favourite kind of riffs to listen to and favourite kind of riffs to play along to.
I love the verse riff in the first song, Clary. I think that's like a pure Bleed From Within riff. If you were to be like, play me a Bleed From Within riff, I'd play that.
Cast Down, pre-chorus. I think a couple of people might say the same thing here, actually.
There are two moments in Cast Down that are personal favourites, the pre-chorus riff and the mid-late.
The mid-late and Cast Down. In fact, the whole of Cast Down, I fucking love that song.
That is a riff. That's a fucking riff.